I can't seem to remember the new vocabulary that I learned, and I always end up forgetting them because I'm too busy, it's endless, or I am old. You learn lots of vocabulary in high school, and this might ring a bell because you learn vocabulary, French vocabulary, and it never sticks, you forget it. And it's frustrating, it's a lot of hard work that is quite useless because the vocabulary that you learn disappears immediately. But you can actually make it work, and I'm going to show you how with a little walk in the park. I'm here in Grenoble, in Le Parc Paul Mistral, and what you can see behind me, ooh, is La Tour Perret, a famous tower in the middle of the park. I'm Géraldine, your French teacher. Welcome to Come in Française for a special episode. I'm here to help you get better at speaking and understanding everyday modern French. C'est parti! In order to give it a try, let's take 5 examples of French vocabulary. I took my notes with me in the park. The first one is faire les courses. Faire les courses. This is to buy groceries. The second one is une bande annonce de film. Une bande annonce de film. This is the trailer for a movie. The third one is un mariage. Un mariage, which both mean a wedding and a marriage. Then we have des couverts. Des couverts, it is cutlery. And at last, un trompe-l'œil. Un trompe-l'œil, it is this kind of painting where they're going to try to trick your eye, literally, in order for you to see something that isn't there, because the painter is really good. But how can you remember those words? Well, it's easy, but it's not obvious at all. It is smart repetition and testing yourself, which is not cramming vocabulary as much as you can in your head in order to try to make it stick. No, this is much more smarter. Basically, when you're learning new vocabulary, you don't spend too much time on it at first. You let it sit on your mind, and then you will come back to it later, then a few weeks later, and then a few months later. And this is how effective vocabulary learning works, with spaced repetition. For a first repetition, we can start with 3 of the vocabulary that we saw at the beginning of the video, which is faire les courses, buying groceries, remember? We have une bande annonce de film, une bande annonce de film, which is a movie trailer, and we have un mariage, a wedding, un mariage. This is your first repetition and it's starting to stick already, which is really good. Now, when reviewing the vocabulary, you can read it and do all the learning over and over, or you can use the testing effect. The testing effect was discovered by scientists, and it shows that in order to learn something, instead of learning it by reading it over and over and over again, testing yourself works much better. Even if there's no feedback on the test, using your brain to try to guess something is way more efficient. So let's start with the first test. What is découvert? What is un trompe-l'œil? This is your first test, and that's really good. You can unite repetition and smart testing in 2 main ways. You can either move to France so that you will need the vocabulary over and over in conversations, or you can design your studying techniques yourself. This is where flashcards are very useful. You can either make them yourself, like I did for music theory, for example, or you can use a software such as Quizlet, which I've heard lots of good things about. The idea is to have your own set of flashcards so you can test yourself on, for example, 10 random words every day, so that you can actually start remembering effectively the vocabulary that you learn and start using it in French conversations. And obviously, this is where the fun starts, because you can use culture to add some fun to your cards, French songs, you can add French movies to it, you can also use other kinds of testing such as quizzes, you can make puzzles, you can make crosswords, anything that you like in order to test yourself. I know that some students like to talk to their dog to practice their vocabulary. Again, the idea is to use and actively test yourself to remember the vocabulary that you learned. So talking to your dog is a really good idea. Cats seem to work very well as well. Games are a really good way to learn French vocabulary, and this is why I created the 30-day French challenge by request from the students who wanted to learn French vocabulary effectively. During the 30-day challenge, you're going to learn 100 new French words with me in just 30 days. It's going to start on July 1st, 2020. I'm saying that in case you're watching this in the future, and registrations close this week. We're going to cover lots of different topics. Art, food, romance, French culture. It's going to be fun, and you're going to be able to meet French students from all around the world and learn all this together. As I said, you can already join the 30-day challenge. It's going to be closing by the end of the week, and we are starting on July the 1st. You have all the information, I think, on my right, I hope. You can click there and get all the details about the 30-day French challenge, and I hope to see you in the challenge again. I'm really excited about this, a bit stressed because this is completely new, and I hope to see you there.